Namaste to all. Myself Amit Kanti, and the study which I am going to present today is titled as Neural Correlates of Cognitive Performance in Type 2 Diabetes Mellitus Patients Following Yoga Practice, a pilot study. And it is being done under the supervision of Dr. Deepeshwar Singh from SUSA, Bangalore. So let us discuss about why and how about this study. Okay, why a study, first of all? We all know diabetes is very common to us, okay? But what we less know is that it is also a risk factor for cognitive dysfunction or cognitive impairment. And cognitive functions are very important factors or functions for us to do daily activities, okay? So diabetes is a risk factor for that also. Hence, it is important to look at that aspect. And the why of the study includes the second factor is yoga. There are a number of evidences which say that yoga is helpful in managing your diabetes. It helps to regulate your glucose levels or control your glucose levels. Okay, so but why? What we don't know is, or what we less know is, whether yoga helps to improve cognitive functions or cognitive performance in diabetic patients. Okay, we do know that yoga helps to improve cognitive functions in healthy and student population, but in diabetes or clinical population, there are very, studies are very scarce. Okay, then how about this study comes into picture there? To answer this question, the EEG, electroencephalography, comes into picture. Okay, so the studies which have been trying to explore this aspect generally try to see which are the domains which are affected. So there are very less interventional studies which try to see how these domains are affected. So electroencephalography is a neuroimaging tool which helps you to look at the neuronal activities of your brain, okay? So the USP of EEG is you can look at the cognitive processes in milliseconds. So that's how the fast your cognitive functions happen, and EEG is a perfect tool to assess those cognitive performances in that millisecond, to the millisecond of information, okay? So that is all about how and why about this study, okay? So how we did this, we took 35 to 65 years of age of diabetic people who are cognitively healthy and who are diabetic for more than about 2 years and who are free of any other comorbidities or complications, or they do not have any psychological problems, okay? So if these people met this criteria, we included them for the study. We assessed their cognitive health through the Montreal Cognitive Assessment. Total, there were 14 participants in our study, okay? So the study was for about a week. On the day one, they were assessed using EEG and the cognitive task, which is Wisconsin card sorting test, and they were assessed their glucose levels and insulin levels, and they were given intervention for about a week for 7 days. And then again, they were assessed using the same assessment tools, okay? So this is their common yoga protocol, which is recommended by Ministry of Ayush for diabetic patients. The same protocol was followed by all of the participants for a week for 60 minutes per day, which included Surya Namaskara, Sukshmayama, Kriyas, Pranayama, and Asanas. So the what were the assessment tools were being used? As I said, EEG, which was 128 channel EEG provided by EGI, and the cognitive task, which was Wisconsin card sorting test, which was presented using E-Prime Stimulus Presentation software. We assessed their blood glucose levels and insulin, fasting insulin levels. So this is an ongoing study, and data collection part is over. Data is still in analysis phase, okay? But what we are expecting is an outcome. We are expecting an outcome in terms of time domain analysis of EEG, which is called ERP analysis. We are trying to look at N1 and P300 component of the cognitive processes, because diabetic patients are shown to affect these two components distinctly or significantly. So that's what we are trying to see, how these components are get affected or get benefited by the yoga practice. And their neurocognitive performance will be assessed based on the reaction time and their accuracy levels of performing the task. Then what are the changes in their glucose levels and insulin levels before and after yoga. And the same glucose and insulin levels will be correlated with their neurocognitive data and their ERP components, so that we can get an idea that if at all yoga helps to improve their cognitive performance, how does it help? What is the mechanism which helps to improve their cognitive performance in type 2 diabetic patients? So though we are trying to explore the mechanism, there are already mechanisms, potential mechanisms through which yoga explored, through which yoga seem to help type 2 diabetic patients. Okay, so it is not unifactorial, it is multifactorial, multisystemic. Okay, so yoga does help improving your cognitive functions by down regulating the sympathetic activity through HPA axis, which can also alter your mood and hence improving your cognitive performance. It can also enhance your neuroplasticity to improve cognitive performance. It also helps you to benefit you cognitively by enhancing your cardiovascular fitness, which ultimately leads to your cerebral circulation, better cerebral circulation, and upregulation of neurotrophins, which leads to brain plasticity. So these are the potential mechanisms through which yoga intervention may help you. Now, where do our studies stand here? As I said, yoga does show benefit to improve, does show to benefit your cognitive functions, but most of them are done using student population, healthy population. There are studies are very scarce which use clinical population or diabetes to explore the mechanism how yoga would help to improve their cognitive performance. So this is one of its kind, and hence we hope to come up with the good results. These are the references of my study. Thank you.